Everyone, so this is the summary of the poem Sea Fever by John Masefield. So these are the important points. This poem was published in 1902 in the collection Salt Water Ballads. This poem is about the speaker's love of a sailor's life. The speaker longs for the freedom and adventure that he experiences on the sea. So this is the text of the poem. I must go down to the seas again, to the lonely sea and the sky, and all I ask is a tall ship and a star to steer her by, and the wheels kick and the wind song and the white sails shaking, and a grey mist on the sea's face and a grey dawn breaking. I must go down to the seas again, for the call of the running tide is a wild call and a clear call that may not be denied. And all I ask is a windy day with the white clouds flying, and the flung spray and the blown spume and the seagulls crying. So when the poem opens, the speaker expresses his deep desire to return back to the ocean, to the sea life. He really enjoys a sailor's life. He is fascinated by the vast open sky and the lonely sea. He just wants a ship and a star to navigate his ship. He longs to witness the adventure when the strong winds will take the sail forward. He would also love to hold the helm strongly. He would witness the silver fog on the surface of the water when sun will rise in the morning. Next, the speaker says that he can't ignore the strong call to go back to the ocean, as the experiences of being on ship fills his heart with excitement and adventure. He would witness strong winds on sea driving the clouds away. He would also watch the foam on the water of the ocean. He would also listen to the cries of the seagulls. So he's longing for all of these kinds of adventures on the sea. Must go down to the seas again, to the vagrant gypsy life, to the gull's way and the whale's way, where the wind is like a whetted knife. And all I ask is a merry yarn from a laughing fellow rover, and quiet sleep and a sweet dream when the long trek is over. So in these lines, the speaker makes it clear that he really enjoys roaming on the ocean like gypsies. He wishes to see the place where seabirds and whales live and where wind blows like a sharp blade of a knife. He longs to hear the stories from his fellow wanderers about their experiences, and he would also love to enjoy a sound sleep when his journey ends. So here the poem ends.